Hey guys, John here, back with another video, and this is not AA related, but you know, it's, I did mention in my previous video where I was going to talk about either a character, my favourite character, Ultra Magnus, or a review. I've not really got time to do reviews till after Auto Assembly, and I really don't want to do a review till I have the masterpiece version of Ultra Magnus, so I'm going to wait till then. And doing this review and this figure kind of gets you guys to know me a little bit better. And also other stuff, you know, you can speak to me about at AA. I'm sure we'll have lots to speak about anyway. Right, so, disclaimer, you're probably hearing hissing in the background. That's just my son's baby monitor. I need it on, obviously. I'm the only one in the house, the wife's at work. Sorry. I'm sure it won't bother you too much. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to speak about my childhood experiences with Ultra Magnus, and then move on to my adult experience with the figure now, how I feel about him, why I relate to him, stuff like that. Right, so, starting off with my childhood experience with the figure. I never had this figure. I never owned him. He was unobtainable. My parents tried. We had a Woolworths here, you know, Toys R Us in Edinburgh, plenty of toy shops up there. We could just never get the figure. It was just impossible to get. And, you know, people I was in school with, same age as me, there was one guy a year above me. He just wasn't there. They somehow managed to get Ultra Magnus, but I didn't. Which made me want him even more, because I was always fascinated by the figure. Why was he a white Optimus Prime? Was he just Optimus Prime in different colours? Obviously I know the reason why now, but back then it was a mystery. Oh, just about popping off there. So yeah, and when it came to, you know, the Transformers cartoon, six of the episodes I had heavily involved Ultra Magnus, them being Fighter Flea, Call of Primitives, okay, not so much that one, Carnage and C Minor, Ultimate Weapon, and the two-parter Return of Optimus Prime. Which made me just want the figure even more, because that was even my favourite character, and I really wanted to get the figure. But I never could, even at car boots. However, now being an adult and in my early 20s, I did have an Ultra Magnus figure, a boxed one at that. But as you do in your early 20s, you're still finding yourself, gaining confidence, learning stuff about yourself. You have the old identity crisis now and again, and I ended up selling all my G1 Transformers that I'd bought in that year. I even started the Takara collection that was just fresh out at the time. But, you know, I regret it now, but hindsight is what it is. And now I have the figure anyway, and he is complete. He's not boxed, but I'm not a mint and box collector, so it doesn't really matter. It's not just him I have. I have quite a lot of iterations of the character. And when it comes to collecting Ultra Magnuses, the simple rule is I don't have any white Optimus Primes. It's that isn't Ultra Magnus to me. It might be to some people, but to me, no. All the iterations of the character I have are official ones. Apart from one WST, KO, and the Diaclone colours, because I'd really love to get the Diaclone version of this guy, but that just ain't gonna happen. The prices for that figure are sky high, complete. But you know, KO, WST one will do me just fine. Saves on display space as well. Shelf space. Excuse me. So as for the character, particularly the Generation 1 character of Ultra Magnus, I identify with him quite well, because while I can have in my job, my previous job at Summerfield, I was a leader, but I just didn't have the confidence to pull it off really, and I wasn't able to say no to a lot of people, so I had to leave that. Moved into my other job, you know where I work now, I'm not going to give them any more free publicity. If you look back at my previous videos, you'll find out where I work if you don't know already. But I'm sure you do, if you're watching me. And so there, if the people above me want, I can, you know, advise them on certain things. You know, maybe how to do something a different way rather than doing it that way, things like that. Or if they're not in, you know, and it's myself and someone else, I'll kind of take the temporary leadership role and what to do, things like that. Only sometimes, of course, but that's how we relate to the character. I'm not the most confident of people when it comes to leadership, maybe just in general. You'll find out when you see me at AA. and I'm trying to think of anything else really before I sign off. It has to be a quite quick video because I'm scared. My son's going to wake up and I'm going to have to, you know, go settle him back down. Things like that. I'm sorry if the lighting's a bit pish. It's, you know, it's night time, there's nothing to do about that. But I hope this video has been somewhat informative as to why I like the character. If there's anything I've missed or anything you'd like to know about why I like the character that I might have not mentioned, please leave me a comment and I'll do my best to answer it in the comment section. Or even at AA. I'm going to stop saying that right now. So until my next video, or at that particular convention that I'm going to in a couple of weeks' time, I'll see you later.
Game over!